The Dorabella Variation by Alec Rowe.
And what's more, old fruit? If you're out walking these molten hills of mine after I'm dearly departed, and you hear somebody whistling a tune, don't worry. It'll only be me.
God's sake!
Criticize my driving when you can drive.
What's the rush?
Maybe you might just want to get back to the hotel and work.
Here we go.
Oh, no, no, no.
You all right, darling?
Yes!
She's scared, Bridget. You're driving too fast.
Luke, you must work. If you don't put in the hours, what's the point in us coming here?
15
love. You don't write, so you know nothing about writing.
15 love.
I teach writing. English literature is my subject.
30, 15.
You don't teach writing. You teach your students how to criticise writers. And if you think that's the same thing, then you're a fool.
30 all.
If I'm such a fool, how come I'm the one paying the hotel bill?
Oh!
What's the matter, darling? Do you feel sick?
Yes! Sick of you two!
What are you doing?
Going on and... on!
Oh, for God's sake.
Dora, where do you think you're going?
Anywhere.
Dora!
Let her go.
Don't tell me what to do with my child.
She's not a child. She's 16.
Dora!
And how are you feeling, Dora? You don't mind if we shout at each other all the time, do you, Dora? Did you enjoy the visit to Hereford, Dora? No, Mummy!
Dora!
No chance.
You're right. She's not a child anymore.
You should have brought along a friend for her.
Oh, I knew it would be my fault.
That's not what I meant.
Dora hates arguments. She saw her fair share with her father and me. Then there was the divorce. Now there's us.
I'm sorry. Did Dora always have that stammer?
Not a word we mention, please. Yes, I guess it got worse recently.
I wish I knew what you wanted, Bridget.
I just want things to get better between us, like they were at the beginning.
And where does the book come into it?
I want you to fulfill your potential. You've got to stay focused.
I try, Bridget. The words just aren't happening.
It's just another bad patch, and every great writer's been through it sometime or other. This is why we're here. Change of scenery, change of routine. Luke, I don't expect you to slave your guts out. If it sometimes sounds that way, it's not. Things will get better. Trust me.
Listen to you. No wonder you are our favourite lecturer. Come here. I'm a lucky man.
Not as lucky as me. Oh, I suppose someone had better go after her.
I'll go.
No, it had better be me. Where is she exactly?
You see the group of trees at the top.
Oh, God.
Go on, the exercise will do you good. And I bet it's some view once you get up there.
Wow. Impressive or what?
Or what?
Hello?
The view is impressive or what? Majestic? Awe-inspiring?
Who is this? Where are you?
If we are perfectly quiet, perhaps someone will sing for us.
Please, who is this?
And here he is. Good afternoon, Sir Blackbird. I always think of blackbirds as aristocrats. If only the aristocracy were half as musical.
This isn't funny.
You've alarmed Sir Blackbird.
I'm hearing you like I hear my Walkman.
Your what?
In the centre of my head.
It's a moderately pretty head. May I inquire who inhabits it?
Where are you?
What's your name, young lady?
Is this a joke?
Sort of joke.
I don't know.
Young woman, I'm politely asking your name, that is all.
Dora.
Dora. Oh, Dorabella.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you don't. There you are. That's Dorabella.
I'm out of here.
Careful. Are you all right?
Yes.
You walked right into me. What's wrong?
Nothing. Let's go.
Well, I was hoping for a bit of a breather. Oh, this is a wonderful view. How far do you think we can see?
I want to go down to the car.
What's the matter? Is there somebody else up here?
Can you see anybody else?
All right, take it easy. I never knew you had grand old Duke of York tendencies.
How much longer have we got to stay in this place?
Oh, we haven't long arrived. All couples argue, you know that.
Whatever.
Slow up, Dora, for God's sake. I thought you liked Morven.
Did I say I didn't?
Wave back to Luke.
I'll just get up. Upset, that's all.
Is it Luke?
Doesn't matter.
Luke has talent. His book could, really could, be very good.
Yeah, if he ever finishes it.
Oh, I should have told you to bring a friend for company.
God, no.
Hello, you two. Which of you is the grand old Duke of York?
We've done that one.
Oh, right.
Dorabella.
What?
Finished with that cup?
What did you say?
The tune you were playing, Dorabella, Edward Elgar.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's someone in Malvern who's never heard of Edward Elgar.
Of course I've heard of him.
Well, he wrote the tune you were playing. It's called Dorabella.
Where is he now?
Elgar? Dead ages ago. On your own again tonight, then?
No.
Okay, okay. Your name's Dora, right?
Everybody wants to know my name.
I'm Richard.
So?
Just trying to be friendly.
Anyway, how do you know my name?
Hotel register.
That's meant to be private.
No, it's not. Look, I just thought since we're just about the only people here under 80...
That's stupid.
Okay, I give up. Bye, Miss White. More coffee, Mrs. Kemp. Mr. Kemp.
See you, Richard.
I worry about Dora. Did you lock the door?
Yes, I did. And don't worry about Dora. Worry about me.
You're old enough to look after yourself.
So is she.
What do you think?
About Dora?
Well,
what is there to think?
Okay. Should I be in bed with you for a start?
That's a bit late to be asking that after 6 months, isn't it?
But it's different here. We've always been discreet before. Well, fairly discreet. Certainly never under the same roof as Dora. This is being a bit confrontational. Oh, maybe I should have got a separate room.
I thought we agreed. A child she is not. She'll cope.
Well, it's easy for you. She's not your child. Help me, Luke. What do you think she thinks?
I think there's too much thinking in this bed. Shut your eyes. You like that, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Forget Dora. Concentrate on me. Your Dora's the straightforward, sensible type that nothing ever happens to.
Hello? My name is Dora White. I'm 16. And I feel like a right idiot up here talking to whatever it is I'm talking to. I was here yesterday. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, then, I go.
Dorabella.
My name isn't Dorabella.
I know that. Shh. He's a little cautious. You frightened him yesterday. Good afternoon, my lord. Pray continue.
I don't understand this. You speak in the middle of my head.
Look at that view. I never tire of it. Herefordshire and Worcestershire spread at your feet all the way to the Welsh mountains. Impressive, or majestic, or awe-inspiring, or what?
Who are you? Why is this special to you?
I doubt I could make you, or anyone, understand. Not with words. Music, yes, maybe. Come along, there's a track just behind you. No dawdling.
Can I ask you something? Are you a ghost?
Prefer spirit. Spirit of the age. Hail to thee, blithe spirit. It sounds less dead.
Wow.
Bow, wow, the watchdogs bark. People say the damnedest thing these days. Where do you live?
London. Notting Hill. Well, Queensway, really.
Holiday?
Sort of.
Sort of? There you go again. Bow, wow, sort of. The King's English, if you please.
The King's English?
Let's try again, young lady. Dora. Dorabella, are you on holiday?
I'm here with my mother and her... I don't know what to call him exactly. She's 40 this year and he's 24. Boyfriend sounds a bit silly.
Entirely agree.
Partner sounds like they're dancing.
Agree again. Swain? Paramour? Inamoratus? What does your father call him? I know what I would in his place.
My dad lives in America. With his new wife and family.
America? The land of vulgarity and general horror.
He seems to like it.
Well, more fool him. I didn't. And what is your role in the interesting arrangement twixt mother and Swain? Duenna?
What's that?
Chaperone.
They're past that stage.
Pity.
There's the age thing. We're not allowed to mention that. But I think they really love each other.
Oh, romantic slush, young lady.
Luke. That's his name, the Swain. He was one of Mum's star students at college. After he left, he sent her some chapters of this book he'd started writing. She thinks it's really good. Well, that was last year, and anyway, now he can't finish it. He's got writer's block. We're not allowed to mention that, either. And Mum thought it would be a good idea to bring him somewhere new.
Work of the imagination seldom runs to form, young lady, and hardly ever to order.
That's what he says.
And where are you all staying?
Cobwell Road, Malvern. The hotel's called the Wellingtonian.
At the foot of the hills. Immense redwood tree outside, hence the name. Used to be a house called Witchcrest. Went there once to lunch. Oh, halt! Turn to your left. You see the little group of houses down there? A village called Storage. And not far away, see the turn on the other side of the road? That's the way to Birchwood Lodge. Wonderful place to work.
What work?
What work? Dear girl, you are a hoot.
Don't laugh at me, please.
Oh, dear. The child can't take a joke.
And I don't like being patronised, either.
Then the rest is silence. Hamlet.
I know. Who's Dorabella?
A dear, dear friend.
And that's her name?
Her name was Dora Penny. I called her Dorabella.
Why?
A quotation from Cosi fan tutte.
Tell me about her.
Pretty little thing. Just like you.
You liked her, then?
Oh, she liked me. Silly young girl once cycled to Birchwood from her home in Wolverhampton. Just to see me. 40 miles on that bone shaker of hers.
You were famous, were you then?
I beg your pardon.
Did I say something wrong?
Have you any idea of what you have said and to whom you have said it?
No.
Well, I'll be damned. Dorabella had a stammer, too. You can hear it in the music.
What music? I don't understand. You wrote tunes, yes?
I think I may claim that.
Did you write the Dorabella tune? Were you Edward Elgar?
Oh, good. This is like charades. It's possible.
I want to understand. Help me.
Damned if I will. I'll give you this. I composed a piece, wrote it at Birchwood down there.
The theme was a puzzle, an enigma. And I made musical pictures of a few dear friends. The Enigma Variations. There. That's it. Explanation over, and all you'll get.
Did you do a picture of Dorabella?
She's there, yes. You just need to listen. Enough for today, Dorabella. Off you go. Back down to that peculiar bicycle of yours.
It's called a mountain bike.
I'm sure it is. Whatever the name of the ugly thing, ride it carefully back to Witchcrest. That road's not as peaceful as it once was. And, young woman?
Yes?
Come to Birchwood tomorrow.
Thank you. Yes, I will. Goodbye. Thank you.
You were famous, were you? Sing up, my lord. Sing it out for me. Was I famous? I was damned famous, stupendously famous, extraordinarily famous.
Hi, Mum.
Where have you been? Nobody in the hotel knew where you'd gone. Where did you get that bike?
Oh, God. You and Luke have been fighting. Is it the
book? Think, breathing, book.
Book.
He won't work.
But he can't work. That's why we're here, isn't it?
Can't work, won't work, and now it's 6 o'clock. Time for the large vodka. It's supposed to be a reward for a good day's writing, for God's sake.
I don't know what to say.
I'm supposed to be going to a chamber concert in the town tonight. I can't leave him in this state.
What state is he in?
Sorry for himself. Angry, resentful, take your choice.
Mum, work of the imagination seldom runs to form and hardly ever to order.
Don't you start.
Anyway, you give him money, you look after him. You help him with his writing. What would he do without you?
That's what I'm scared of. Will you go up and talk to him?
Me? What can I say?
Reassure him. Give him, I don't know, confidence. Love.
All right.
Oh, forget all that personal stuff. That was just me upset.
Mum, you're not going to marry him or anything, are you?
Trust me. Once was enough.
Your mother is in many ways a clever and perceptive woman, but she just doesn't understand.
Understand what?
Me, you, writing, everything. No wonder you've got a stammer.
No one's supposed to mention that.
Do you think it's the age thing with her?
Nobody's supposed to mention that, either.
Along with writer's block, you mean?
Or that.
Pass me a new bottle of vodka from the wardrobe, will you? Why can't all hotels have mini-bars?
I don't know. I don't know what a mini-bar is.
What do you think? Does the age thing matter? Are people laughing at me?
I don't think so.
Can you see any tonic?
There's a bottle in the wardrobe.
I'll leave it. Now come here to me. Look at us both in the mirror. Look at that. We are youth.
You're 24.
We are one generation.
Are we?
And the next time you see Bridget, look at her face. Closely.
I think Mum's really pretty.
Yes. Yes, of course you do. The loneliness of the artist, Dora. Bridget doesn't understand.
Are you crying? Are you drunk?
The whole mad business is crazy. She should never have started it.
You started it? You sent her chapters and things. She believes in you.
That's the problem.
Why?
Give me a hug.
All right.
This is good. This is positive. This is what I need.
I'll get you the tonic. So, how's it coming along? The book.
You want the truth? I'm sick of the book. Sick of thinking what comes next. Sick of lectures on structure, character balance, and motivation.
But you must have written something today.
Not a word.
What have you been doing then?
Sketching new chapters, revising old chapters, doodling, dozing, sharpening pencils. But new words, zero, zilch, nix, nothing.
Cheers.
You'll finish it. I know you will. And it will be wonderful and make you rich and famous.
You believe that?
Yes.
You really do? This is important.
Yes.
Kiss me.
All right.
Thank you. For your youth and beauty and belief in me.
That's all right.
Again.
I don't think so.
Please.
Then I go. Okay?
I thought I'd just look in and see...
Oh, hi, Mum.
Bridget. Your daughter is a rare rouser of spirits.
So long as that's all she's rousing.
Mother!
Off with you. Both of you. You to your concert and you to wherever it is you want to be. Order me sandwiches and a pot of coffee. Tonight, I work late.
This staircase is way over the top. You can't walk down it without coming over all regal.
What did you do? What did you say?
Nothing, really.
Amazing. Whatever it was, it did the trick.
What?
I'm so relieved. Thank you, darling. Mwah. Look, come to the concert. Supper's included in the ticket.
I'll be fine.
What will you do?
Don't know.
Maybe the dishy young waiter can suggest something.
Which waiter?
Well, I thought you might have noticed him. He's the one who keeps trying to catch your eye.
Really?
Yes.
This one.
Excuse me.
Mum! Oh, God, no.
Can I help?
Coffee and sandwiches for one in room 7, and I'll be missing dinner tonight. I don't know about my daughter.
I'll lay up your table for one, then, shall I?
Dora, what do you want to do?
Nothing.
You must eat, darling.
Not hungry.
Coffee and sandwiches for one. Room 7. A variety?
That'll be fine. He'll need more coffee later.
No problem. I'll see to it.
Thank you. I'm afraid, we don't know your name.
Richard, Mrs. White.
Thank you, Richard.
You're welcome.
You can be so embarrassing.
I understand teenagers. Give them an inch and they'll take a centimetre. You need a push now and then. Actually, he is quite dishy.
For God's sake.
That's a tight little bum.
Just shut up, will you? I'm going up to my room.
15 all, I think you'd say, darling.
Yes?
Coke, sandwiches, crisps.
I didn't order anything.
It's a freebie. I'm off duty. I thought you might like some company.
I'm not hungry, and I don't.
Well, it's really hard work. You know that.
I didn't ask you to come. What do you want?
Oh, I don't want anything. I don't expect anything. Why are you so jumpy?
I'm not.
Take it easy, for God's sake. You're a respected guest, and I'm a humble waiter. I'm risking my job doing this.
All right.
Make some room, then.
Where?
Dressing table.
Okay.
Here we go. Right.
Hey, I was watching that.
If you're worried about the guy, I took him more coffee half an hour ago and he's hard at it. Your mother's boyfriend?
None of your business.
What's he writing?
Book. Novel.
Any good?
Brilliant.
Not what Abby says. She looked at it when she was doing the room.
Then that's all she knows. My mother's a senior lecturer in English, and she says it could be very good.
Why is it offensive all the time?
People let you down.
What?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
No, come on. Why'd you say that?
Because you keep on about it. Was this place always called the Wellingtonia?
No. Used to be a private house.
Witchcrest?
Yes. Want that cheese and ham?
God, don't you have any manners?
Not when I haven't eaten since midday.
I don't think you're a very polite waiter.
I'm in my first year at uni. Manchester. Engineering. This is a holiday job. Okay, then. My big surprise. Well, the first one, anyway. The book.
What book?
This book. About Elgar. Life story and that. Between page 128 and 129... Here you go. Who's this?
I don't know.
She's the dead image of you.
Is she?
Old photo, so you can't tell what colour her eyes are. But they're dark, like yours. And look at the eyebrows. Same dark hair, too. Take the book. Some guest left it here years ago. That's Dorabella. And this, second surprise, all set up and ready to go, is a tape of the music you were crucifying in the lounge yesterday. The tape belongs...
Shut up, Richard.
Take it easy.
It's incredible. It's how she moves. Fussy little steps. It's how she speaks. It's how she thinks. It's everything about her. Like he said, it's her.
Yeah?
She's fluttery. Flirty. No, it's him that's flirty. They're both flirty.
Him?
Listen. There's feelings going on underneath she doesn't realise. Or understand.
Dora, you okay?
Yeah. No. Look, can I keep these tonight?
Keep them as long as you like.
This is amazing.
What's my reward for two nice surprises?
Not now.
Are you really into this?
You won't understand.
Try me.
Richard, can you just go, please?
Go?
I can't explain.
This is seriously weird.
Yes.
I'll take the tray down.
Come here. Thanks for everything.
Even after that, you want me to go?
Especially after that.
I will never understand women.
Shh!
Dora, she doesn't look that much like you. I mean, the hair's all wrong. And the dress. Dora? Okay, I'm away. See you, Dora. Don't get so far into it, whatever it is, that you can't get out.
Again. Dora Penny, Dora White. Would I have liked you? Would you have liked me? Does it matter? Why does it matter? Hello? Hello?
You found your way then?
Easy. Just like you said. The turn opposite Storage Church. Funny name for a village.
There was a young lady of Storage who would only eat bay leaf and porridge. I'm very pleased you came.
Did you think I wouldn't? Where's Birchwood Lodge?
Turn and behold. There it is. It's changed a bit. It's been added to. It's changed rather a lot, actually. Just a few rooms when we knew it. Drop your conveyance under the hedge. Your mountain bicycle. It'll be safe enough. Nobody would steal a thing like that.
Oh, the sun is so good. What do I call you?
What sort of question is that?
What did Dorabella call you?
His Excellence.
His Excellence? That is so gross.
It is no such thing.
I'll call you Edward.
If you don't mind, I should prefer Sir Edward.
You're a sir. Wow.
Bow wow.
That's impressive.
It is a fact.
I listened to all of your Enigma variations last night.
Were you impressed by those too?
The music was so sad.
Well, there are jolly bits. Dan the Bulldog. Townsend on his tricycle. Do you hear him ringing his blasted bell?
Yes. But it just felt sad. Like you were missing your friends already. Does that make any sense?
Nostalgia, you mean. Longing for the past. Oh, yes, they accused me of that even when...
You were alive.
Quite. Maybe I could sense the changes ahead, just round the corner. Enormous changes. Not for the better.
I don't listen to that kind of music much. But it sounded lonely, too. Were you a lonely person?
Lonely? Tommy rot. Friends by the score. Friends in the score, if we're talking of the variations, what?
You can be lonely in a crowd.
You're a clever girl. Yes, the truth is, writing is a lonely business, if you take the game seriously. Lonely work, Dorabella. Music or words.
Luke talks a lot like that. He gets terribly depressed. Yesterday he cried.
Then cheer him up. That's your job. That's what Dorabella used to do for me. You're important to him, but pick your moments. Never intrude. Sometimes the loneliness leads to great work.
All right.
I remember one summer night here. The sun going down over the hills. Everything golden except me. Some nonsense of music not happening. I lit a cigar, worrying away. Then I felt a hand on my shoulder. And Dorabella...
Damn, lost you to hell! Get back to Hades where you belong, you brutes! You ugly brutes! Get out of my skies! You desecrate everything!
They were just a couple of planes.
Damn, blast all war engines.
Time to go.
Oh, I can stay longer.
Time to go.
All right.
War.
We never learn. The Great War made me ill, you know.
Did you fight in France?
What would you know about it?
But we did World War I as a GCSE module.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about.
Okay. There's the road. I know what you look like.
How do you know?
I saw your picture.
What picture? Where?
In a book. You were playing a piano.
Damned handsome fellow, wasn't I?
I suppose.
You suppose? Is that all?
You look very serious.
If I'd known that a pretty young thing would one day be inspecting me, I would have smiled.
I don't think it's proper for a ghost to flirt.
A spirit, if you please.
Or even less proper for a spirit, Your Excellence.
Mm. Now who's flirting?
I am not.
Hoity-toity.
Can I come tomorrow?
Top of the hill, where Sir Blackbird sings. But be careful on your way back. Watch out at the Storage Road Junction. Motors tear by like fury.
All right. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Dorabella. There was a young lady of Storage who would only eat bay leaf and borage. She cooed as she chewed this ridiculous food and preferred it to kippers and porridge. Ding, 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 ding. Sweet lovers love the spring. Remember, you're a writer. Cheer the chap up. Like you've just done for me. It better be worth it.
You! Another bottle of Côte de Rhône.
Please don't shout.
Yes, miss. No, miss. Whatever you say, miss. I'm not in your lecture room now.
Don't do this, please. People are looking.
Let them.
I only said...
I know what you said.
Luke.
You inferred I was an expensive liability.
I said my bank statement was a shock. I said we can't stay here for as long as I'd hoped.
I'll drink to that. Cheers.
If you drink now, you won't get anything done this afternoon.
Yeah, this afternoon will have turned out exactly like this morning. Don't nag. Do you think I like it any more than you do?
Luke, please, don't drink anymore. I don't want to fight.
Maybe it's over.
What is?
Your great Pygmalion experiment. Maybe a nasal's ear never intended for pursuit. That's rather good.
Don't think like that, Luke. Be strong.
With you, always carping, criticizing,
Undermining. I half expect you to grade every page C-.
You're embarrassing people.
Oh, these? You're worried about these? This is geriatrics not so anonymous. And you know what they're thinking? They're thinking, look at that angry young man with that old, old, old woman.
Excuse me.
You! Are you deaf? I said another Cote de Rhone.
Hello.
Hello.
Sorry I'm late.
That's all right.
What are you reading?
Pride and Prejudice.
Oh, God. You only read Jane Austen when you're depressed.
How do you feel about going home?
When?
Any time. Tomorrow. Now?
Is that Luke's book in the waste bin?
He put it there, not me.
Where is he?
Don't know. Don't care. Go and get lunch before they shut up shop.
Oh, it sounds awful. I'm glad I missed it.
So am I. Shut the rest of the dining room up, I can tell you.
Poor man.
Everybody was really sorry for her. I bought him his bottle, but he only had two glasses before he took off.
Where?
No idea. Out.
So, what's his latest surprise?
Look through into the lounge. The old lady, right?
In the corner?
Mrs. Tilsley, one of the residents. Nearly 90, lived in the hotel for years. You want to meet her?
No, I don't.
You absolutely do. You're having coffee together. I've fixed it.
Alice and Edward Elgar. Oh, yes. Mother knew them well as any ordinary person was allowed to know them, that is.
How do you mean?
They preferred the company of people with money and status.
Did they live here all their lives?
Oh, dear me, no. They began married life in London.
But he loved the countryside.
So he did, dear. But it didn't stop him living just off the Cromwell Road, then Norwood. Oh, and they spent 10 years in Hampstead. And when he was on his own again, he took a flat near Buckingham Palace. He would enjoy that.
But this is where he was really happiest, yes?
He came back to Malvern for his last few years. Mind you, he was far too grand to bother with the Tilsleys by then.
What about his wife?
Oh, a little more cream, dear. Thank you. Alice? Oh, she was cut out of family wills for marrying beneath her, you know.
But he was a sir. He had a knighthood.
Oh, yes, dear, after a while. But it only returned her to the class from which he'd removed her. Her father was a major general, remember. His was a piano tuner.
So what was the attraction?
Oh, Alice probably knew what she was about. She met a good-looking piano teacher, saw his potential and took a chance. Confidentially, dear, she was 10 years his senior and not altogether a beauty.
But he was a brilliant composer.
Oh, without her money and encouragement, Mother always thought he'd never have amounted to much. Now, before the marriage and after her death, they say he wrote nothing much of value. He was totally reliant on her. And then, of course, on Caris.
Who was Caris?
His daughter, dear.
His daughter? He never told me. I never knew he had a daughter.
Oh, and all too easy to forget the fact. Poor Caris.
Why poor?
Oh, that's how we always thought of her. Poor, poor Caris. Do you mind if we stop now, dear? I get very tired. I'll finish my coffee and then have a little sleep.
How did you get on?
I can't believe it.
Want to do something? I'm free once to finish this lawn.
No, I've got to get on with that book.
She was interesting, then.
Did you know?
Dora!
Uh-oh. Here comes the writer. I'm right here if you need me.
Oh, I won't.
Dora!
You're drunk.
Pity little Dora.
Keep away from me. You stink of booze.
What's wrong? We're allies, remember? Rebels against the Wrinkleys.
You're too feeble to be a rebel.
What?
You can't even write a book.
Oh, what are you talking about?
You! Without my mother, you would be nothing.
Dora. Don't go. I need you.
Tough!
Dora, where are you going?
Just lately, I'm learning a lot about people like you.
What are you grinning at?
Are you here?
No, no. Sir Blackbird won't sing if you scare him.
Stuff, Sir Blackbird.
Take no notice, my lord. The child is tired and fretful.
Don't patronize me.
I'll do as I please, thank you, Miss Crosspatch. If you're about to be tedious, please leave now.
I was up half the night reading about you. You called your daughter fish face in public.
She did look rather like a fish.
It's not funny. You sent her away to boarding school.
Not for long, and only just up the road. She was a weekly boarder. She could come home most weekends. Great music was demanded of me. I couldn't be disturbed by a clumsy child.
You named her Caris. What sort of a name is that?
A very fine name.
It doesn't even exist. It's just the first bit of her mother's Christian name, Caroline, with the last bit of her second name, Alice, tacked on. Why didn't you write a variation for her?
Don't be ridiculous.
What's so ridiculous? You wrote one for Dorabella.
Altogether different. Dorabella was useful to me.
That's the trouble. You like Dorabella because she sucked up to you. Never contradicted you. Always did what you wanted. Yuck! All that secret flirting.
How dare you? Dorabella was invaluable. We went on walks together. She organized press cuttings. She turned over for me.
She what for you?
Lady Elgar, admirable woman though she was, could not do everything. We were lucky Dorabella was available.
She seems to have been available quite a lot. Didn't your wife ever mind?
I beg your pardon.
I bet there were times she felt really hurt.
She? If you mean Lady Elgar, kindly have the courtesy to say so. If not, shut up.
Did Lady Elgar actually like Dorabella?
They were the best of friends. Dorabella called her dear little person.
Dear little person?
Would you make something out of that now?
You were your excellence. She was dear little person. I'd have strangled her.
Enough. More than enough. You were offensive.
No, you're the one who's offensive. Only you're so conceited, you don't know it.
You presume too much, young woman.
I notice you didn't think twice about putting darling Dorabella's stutter into your music.
Of course not. It was there. I used it.
Oh, of course you did. That wasn't going too far, though, was it?
You are not like my Dorabella at all.
Well, thank God for that.
I was wrong. I have been cheated.
So have I. Composers and writers and probably artists all play on the fact that they're special and need special treatment. But you're not. You're just the same as anybody else.
I thought you understood, girl.
Are you doing this?
Don't you remember the loneliness of the artist?
Yes, and I know why you're lonely. You only think of yourselves. You're all unbearable.
Get off my hills!
They're not your hills! They're not anybody's hills! They're just hills!
How dare you! How dare you! How dare you!
How are you feeling?
All right.
You're looking better than you did 2 hours ago. You gave me the fright of my life.
Some bits I can't remember.
You remember getting here?
I think so. I fell off the bike.
Not for the first time, according to what you told your waiter. You gabbled on about falling off somewhere up in the hills. Thank God he was working outside and saw you wobbling up the road. You gave him the fright of his life too, incidentally.
I feel better now.
You've had a good sleep. Remember the doctor coming?
Yes.
We wondered if you'd been hit by a car, but there aren't any marks. Only these peculiar cuts and grazes on your face and arms. You must have hit a hedge or something when you fell. Anyway, you're here and you're safe and you're not badly hurt. That's all that matters. Sip of water.
Please.
There you go.
I've told Luke you and I are leaving as soon as you're up to it.
What?
This has all been too much for you, and I should have realised it. Anyway, he's going tonight. He wants to say goodbye to you.
No.
No, we're not leaving. No, he's not leaving. Or no, you don't want to see him.
I don't want to see him.
He's genuinely sorry if he's scared or upset you.
What about you? Don't you care that he's scared and upset you?
There's not something I don't know about, is there? Something he's done or said?
It's not just him. They're all the same.
Who are we talking about?
It doesn't matter. Mum, what about the writing? What about his book?
I don't care about his book. I doubt if there'll ever be a book. You're my main concern at the moment. Now, what about a light lunch? Could you manage some scrambled egg?
Don't think so.
Still feel sick?
A bit.
He ought to eat something. Would it help if I ask Richard to bring the tray up and stay for half an hour? Oh, I see it might.
Thanks, Mum.
Give us a kiss. See you later.
What about, you know, what about you and Luke?
No fool like an old fool, isn't that what they say?
You're not old, and he's the fool, not you.
Anyway, now it's over. Writers are interesting, charming, selfish, and childlike, and extremely disappointing. Packed?
Just the bathroom stuff to go. How is she?
Better.
I'll go and say goodbye.
She doesn't want you to.
You mean you don't want me to?
I told her you were leaving. I told her you wanted to say goodbye. She said no.
Why?
I don't know, Luke. Maybe, like me, she's had enough. Her young waiter's taken her something to eat.
So he can visit her, I can't.
That's right. It's called the age thing.
I don't want to go, Bridget.
Did you find out the time of your train?
6:32.
I'll drive you to the station.
We've had differences before. We've always worked it out.
Don't do this, Luke.
Come here.
Not this time. And horror, this is the age thing talking again. I just can't be bothered anymore. I'm too old. I want a bit of calm in my life. I've already got one child. I don't want another.
You can't have another, can you? Aren't you...
Too old? Yes, probably. Actually, I was talking about you.
Scrambled egg, smoked salmon sandwiches and half a bottle of muscadet.
I don't like wine.
Well, I know, but I do. Before you eat, I want to know what happened.
I'm really not hungry.
Okay. I eat, you talk.
I don't think so.
Dora, you said some weird stuff earlier.
Maybe I imagined it.
Are you going to tell me?
I've been meeting Edward Elgar.
Okay.
His ghost. Or spirit. You think I'm crazy?
Maybe. Where?
On the big hill. Once at Birchwood.
What does he look like?
Oh, I don't see him. I mean, I've seen his picture in the book. But I don't see him when we're together. He talks in my head. I remind him of Dorabella, the girl in the book. Dora Penny. Sometimes he thinks I'm her.
Okay.
He's told me loads of things.
Such as?
The sort of things he's the only one who can know. This hotel was Witchcrest. He was a sir, that sort of thing. Well, yesterday I upset him. Oh, this is sounding crazy.
How did you upset him?
The old lady.
Mrs. Tilsley?
She told me loads of things about him. Bad things he said and did. And there was more like that in the book, too. I got a bit carried away. Told him he was selfish and unbearable, and he got angry and sort of made a storm. I panicked and ran down to the road.
How'd you get the cuts and scratches?
Branches whipping at me and bits flying off them. I fell a couple of times. I don't remember everything. It was so scary, Richard. I don't know what's wrong with me.
Nothing's wrong with you. Get some rest. I'll leave a couple of sandwiches on the table for later, just in case. Where's the Elgar book?
Why?
Where is it?
Window ledge. I was going to junk it.
Think you'll be able to get about tomorrow?
Yes.
I'll borrow Chef's car. We'll pay the visit.
Is that a good idea?
It's an excellent idea. Your mum's told the boss Shakespeare's leaving tonight, and you're off tomorrow or the next day. Is that right?
She wants to go home.
What about you?
I don't know. Yes, probably.
What will you do back in London?
Not a lot.
Then don't go.
Well, what would I do instead?
The boss is opening the annex next week. Full bookings until September. She's looking for somebody to help Abby and Rachel. Talk it over with your mum. Possibility?
Possibility?
I'll look in later. Bye.
Bye.
Remember when we saw Brief Encounter at the film club?
This is nothing like Brief Encounter. For starters, this platform bistro has it over that buffet every time. Can you imagine Trevor Howard or Celia Johnson sipping Merlot?
It was a rubbish film anyway.
Luke, good luck. I mean it.
To the future, then. What am I going to do, Bridget? I just want to write.
Then do it.
As easy as that?
Yes.
Well, you don't believe that any more than I do. And how do you know I've got any talent? You're not exactly a disinterested critic.
Come on. The train is leaving the gravy. Let's get you on board.
We could still work this out. I don't have to go.
Oh, yes, you do.
I feel used.
You think I don't? Well, maybe that's just relationships. I use you, you use me. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. That's an idea worth exploring. Here, your manuscript's inside the bag.
Forget it.
Take it. It's worth the work. It really is. Find somebody else who'll drive you on. You need that now. You won't always. I'm sorry, it can't be me anymore.
All right. Why not?
Goodbye, then.
Bye.
We had some good times. You'd better get on.
Actually, you weren't our favourite lecturer. We liked Doc Davis. He didn't care. You cared too much.
Thanks.
You're not brilliant in bed, either.
But you are Luke. I'll miss that. I'll miss you like crazy. I'll miss you. Doc Davis thought you were an idle little tow rag. I was the one who always stuck up for you. Where's the justice? Goodbye, excitement. Hello, middle age.
I don't think he's here.
Okay.
Sometimes there's a blackbird.
Yeah?
Sir Edward? Oh, I feel stupid. Let's go down.
Sir Edward!
Shh. You think this is all crazy? I'm sorry.
Dora, come here.
What?
Just do it.
What are you doing?
Holding you. Put your arms around my neck. Do it, Dora.
What's this all about?
I'm going to snog you, stupid. And you're going to snog me right back.
No, I'm... Wow.
Now we'll see what happens. Well, that's it then. It's all over.
Yes. It's over. It's gone. I think he's gone.
How do you feel?
Relieved. A bit sad. Why wasn't he here?
How do you know he wasn't? It's in the book. The last time Dorabella ever visited the Elgars, she took her fiancé with her. And that was the end of that. Right in his face. Little Dorabella was growing up and wouldn't be coming out to play again. Just for extras, his name was Richard. Say goodbye. We've got a lot to do. We've got to pack your mother off to Notting Hill.
Queensway, well, really.
Whatever. And we've got to work out your timetable with the boss.
Goodbye, then, Sir Edward.
Let's get you down to the road.
Do you really believe me? Really believe what I told you?
I'm an engineer. Just give me facts.
That's what I was afraid of.
Well, here's a fact. You're beautiful and intelligent, and I fancy you rotten.
Shut up, you.
Well, also, you've been sick and worried, and now you're not.
Also, I have a job at the Wellingtonia Hotel for the rest of my holidays.
Also, you have a room two doors away from me.
Also, that could be rather perilous.
Who for?
You. If my mother... Oh, no.
I love it when you do that.
Do what?
Stammer. A real turn-on.
Wow.
Oi! Sir Ed, mate! Cheers! Thanks a load!
Oi, Sir Ed, mate. Lord Blackbird, I ask you.
That was the Dorabella Variation by Alec Rowe. The part of Dora was played by Kate Maberley, and Bridget by Jemma Redgrave. Luke, Jonathan Firth. Richard, Sam Collings. Mrs. Tilsley, Jean Trend. And the spirit of Edward Elgar was played by David Collings. The Dorabella Variation was directed by Celia DeWolf and was a peer production for BBC Radio 4.